Alright, second verse, same as the first, bitchin'. So where is she at? Oh no, she already got her bond, okay. Let's see. If that is to be the case, then let me think. I am to be thinking. Yes. I am to be thinking. There we go. Passion Lip. Now come, let us stoke the fires of hell.
The battle is over. There are no other magical energy signals within 30 meters of our position. I have to apologize again, Senpai. Even after all Da Vinci's reminders to be careful, I still let my guard down. I know I need to be extra vigilant in watching for magical energy signatures and servants, especially since we can't contact the border. And yet I completely failed at that task.
Let's take this reminder of why we need to be more careful.
Right, I promise I won't make the same mistake again. Thank you, Fu, but it's not fair. It's not your fault. You have nothing to apologize for.
How do you know he's apologizing?
If anything, I should be thanking you for alerting us to the danger. So thank you. Fu Fu! Given that we're unable to contact the Shadow Border, we're effectively cut off from Kyoto itself. I need to keep that in mind. In accordance with the Kyoto Personal Code, Article 23, Paragraph 2, it's imperative that I remain calm and proceed with caution. In other words, I'm free to make decisions, act independently, and return to base at my own discretion. And then make an official report, of course.
Kinda seems sparse on the details.
Yes, it is. Dr. Roman added paragraph 2 when no one was looking.
That explains more than it should.
Yes. All right, let's resume our expedition, Senpai. I've confirmed that the Ortenaxa Uller board attachments have been safely shut down and stowed. Initiating standard Ortenax movement mode.
Are you a fucking robot? Do you need to, like, announce every time? Yeah.
Battle mode initiated. Preparing for battle. Orders, master.
That's how she comes off sometimes, so I'm gonna be real.
Since there are a lot of trees in this area, I think it would be better to put the older boards away and move around on foot for a while.
Good idea. Let's do that.
Okay, Senpai. Trees actually made out of ice. I can't tell if they were carved from ice or if all these tree-like formations were stuck in the ground. Either way, I can't imagine there would be much wildlife in a place like this. Woo! That said, I don't know if this is a good thing or not, but based on the magical energy signals I'm sensing, it looks like there are more giants past the ice trees. There are more of them gathered together there than anywhere else I've seen so far. Maybe the path we took to avoid the fiery mountains ended up bringing us to their territory.
Let's try to make sure they don't see us.
Good point. I'll keep that in mind, Master.
Foo, 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 foo!
Yes, Foo. That means we'll be walking from here on.
Foo! Foo!
I can't believe he's already gone that far ahead. Please don't run off too far on your own, Foo. We don't want a giant spotting you. Oh, but then again, maybe it would be okay. You're so cute that even a giant might want to keep you as a pet instead of eating you.
Foo, Foo!
Senpai, can I talk to you about something?
No, but you're going to anyways.
Thank you. Something has been bothering me about him. Sigurd is one of the greatest heroes in all of Scandinavia. He reforged King Sigmund, his father's demonic sword, Gram, after the Divine Spear Gungnir shattered it. Then went on to defeat the dragon Fafnir and gain its wisdom. That all fits with what Holmes told us. Later, he and Brynhild, the Valkyrie, fell in love, but their relationship was poisoned by hate and ended with his death. He has many of the same roots as Siegfried, so much so that some believe they were actually the same hero. And yet, I don't know why, but I didn't get that sense at all from that masked heroic spirit.
He was definitely really strong.
Something keeps nagging at the back of my mind. It's hard to put it into words, but... Senpai, I think I hear some...
Yeah!
Right, it came from the north-northwest. Let's go!
The fuck are you?
Oh no! This saw me! Now what do I do? It was going so well, too!
I don't know, I'll work on a voice later once I actually care.
I don't understand! Why did things never turn out well for me? I'm such an idiot!
Ah, no! Please, no! Eep.
We made it, Master. Please focus on keeping her safe. As for me... I'll handle these giants. You get back to, please, Foo.
Foo, Foo!
What the? Who are you two?
No, you can't. Any child, the... Burgrizar? Find his doom. You have to run away if you see a child being attacked by one of them. I don't understand, why are you doing this? Go on, get out of here. Yeah, not an option.
Huh?
You idiot, now they're going to squish all of us.
No, they won't. We won't let them. Ortenex is holding steady at maximum output. I can do this, Master.
Let's do this.
Right.
This doesn't look any different than fighting a Jotun. I don't see the difference. I don't see the problem.
Let's see. Do I want to fucking have Melt go ahead and fight? No, so many choices. Fuck it, why not? Damn, that almost killed it, actually. Holy shit. Alright, well. It actually ended a lot better than I thought it would. And this guy, well, he was always fucked. He just never knew it. Because he had to deal with, Quilthoth Rhizome?
いくな
Oh, there was a third battle. Oh, you're what the Bergrizzi is. Huh. Mistakes have definitely been made. I did not mean to blow my fucking load early. Should have probably paid attention. There we go. At least I got a crit off that one. You kind of look like a rock Jotun. I don't know if that's what you actually are, but I mean, frankly, I also don't really care. I'm gonna kill you either way. There we go, this ought to finish him off.
Bitchin'.
God, now I gotta think of a voice for this girl.
The battle is over. I don't detect any other magical energy signals within 30 meters. We defeated the giants and ice creatures, but that was the first time we've come across a mountain giant. A Bergrizzi. In Norse mythology, the Brigasar were a race of mountain giants that were on friendly terms with the Jotnar, the frost giants. But I don't remember reading anything about them banding together and attacking humans like that.
Great job out there.
Thank you, Master. I managed to fend off the attackers without sustaining any injury, all thanks to your support, Senpai. The load on the Ortenax is well within its tolerance. Da Vinci did an amazing job tuning it up. Foo, 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 foo! Oh, that's right. Senpai, is that girl?
Brigazar, a lot.
Oh, Heavenly Mother, oh, merciful Goddess, please, I beg of you. Even if the giants do smush me flat, please let me stay with everyone else after I die. Excuse me. Is she speaking Swedish? The talisman doesn't have any problem translating conversation, but it's still a little hard to make out what she's saying. It might just be me, but it kind of sounds like she has a strong accent, too.
All the giants are gone now.
That's right, we're not going to hurt you. I promise you're safe for the moment. I'm alive. There's no more Bergrisar around? That's right, you have nothing to worry about. There are no more giants around here.
Looks around. Relieved sigh.
That's amazing. I can't believe it. The goddess must have sent you. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. You two saved my life. That's so amazing. How did you do it? Usually anyone the giants see ends up getting pancaked.
Who wrote this dialogue? What the fuck?
But none of us are even a little bit squished. Oh, I'm sorry. You're supposed to introduce yourself when you first meet someone, aren't you? I remember learning that. My name's Greta.
Or Gerda. I don't know why I read that as Greta. Gerda? Gerda, maybe.
That's a lovely name you have. It has a wonderful Nordic ring to it. Thanks. I like the way it sounds, too. It's very nice to meet you both, Miss Black Armor and Mr. Black Hair.
I wonder if that would actually change if I was a woman.
What are your names?
Vane.
And I'm Mashkariolite. Vane Izanagi and Mashkariolite, huh? Got it. You two are incredible. I can't believe you really saved me. What village are you from? You don't seem like you're shivering. How can you not be cold with so few layers? I'm nice and warm thanks to my fur coat. I knew I'd have to be ready for anything once I decided to go out on my own. The grown-ups won't help because they're busy getting everything ready for tomorrow, so I have to do it all myself. That includes the cooking and tending to the children who have come down with terrible fevers. Alright, a reward! When someone does something nice for you, you have to repay them. I don't have anything on me right now. I'd have to go back to the village. But I also have to find the medicinal herbs before I go back. What should I do?
God, I want this part to end. I am in desperate need of some fucking water.
Senpai, this is the first Scandinavian we've met. This must mean there are human villages here. And they don't seem to have mutated to adapt to this environment like the Yaga had. Maybe that means their culture is closer to proper human history.
They fucking worship Satan and they eat dogs.
Although, for some reason, her outfit doesn't seem like anything someone would wear in 2020.
I mean, Mash, have you fucking looked around? We literally just got done establishing that this land is nothing but, like, ice filled with magic. The trees aren't even trees, they're just ice-shaped trees. And the mountain is on fire. How people are dressing should be the least of your goddamn concerns.
Regardless, I think she'll be willing to take us to our village. Once we get there, we can ask around.
Right.
Senpai?
Oh, it's okay. She'll only die after we finish everything. You know how it goes. Alright, well, give me half a second. I'm gonna go grab water. Okay, and I'm back. Now I have water. So, let's proceed. This quest is very fucking long.
Foo, foo, foo! Foo, foo, foo!
You're adorable. Come here, it's okay.
Woo, cute!
Oh, that looks fun. Let me try. Hop.
Woo!
You're too pretty to be a mouse. Maybe you're a dog? Or a cat? Oh, I know. You must be a horse.
Horse!
I've never seen any animal besides sheep this close before. You're so beautiful. Oh, but I did see something else beautiful just a little while ago. It was a rainbow. A huge seven-colored rainbow that stretched all the way past the mountains. Nobody else saw it, but I did. Isn't that amazing?
Foo foo!
Yeah, I wish I could have seen it too.
Foo!
I wonder why Foo is in such a good mood. Could it be the weather? Maybe he likes it cold like this. There, look, Senpai. We've only just met Gerda, and Fu has already taken to her. Oh wait, maybe it's the other way around, and Gerda's actually the one who's taken to him?
I don't know.
Yes, she's very cheerful. And it sounds like she came all this way to find special medicine for a friend back in her village. She must be very responsible, too. There's something I'm wondering about, though. She said she was looking for medicinal herbs, right? Does that mean plants can grow around here? Not to mention that, if this is an emergency, why is she out here all by herself? I don't know about other regions in this Lost Belt, but it's no secret dangerous giants roam around here. And of course there's no way an ordinary human could fight a giant alone. They'd be dead for sure.
Tell that to Beowulf. I mean, by technicality, what is the difference between a hero when they were alive and dead? A hero alive, most of the time, was just a person who did extraordinary feats. Unless, of course, they were like part god or something, but even then, still extraordinary feats.
If someone needed to come out here, shouldn't it be an armed group of adults who know how to fight?
In theory. But not always. Must be more we don't know yet. The fuck is this sticky crap on my goddamn phone? Yeah. No, sorry about that. Just crap on my phone.
Are you guys talking about me? That's right. I left my village to look for medicinal herbs. The grown-ups are too busy getting ready for tomorrow, so we kids have to take care of ourselves. And since I'm the big sister, I have to do my best to pull my weight. That's pretty mature of me, right?
Foo Foo!
Is that a compliment? Thank you, Foo. You're such a good boy. Your fur is so pretty, too. It's so soft and smooth.
Foo Foo!
I'm sorry to interrupt, but I'm afraid it's dangerous here. This area seems to be frequented by giants. Yeah, I guess you're right. We only see them occasionally near the village, but I know there's lots of giants around these mountains. Still, there's nothing else I can do. The only one who knows how to use runes is the envoy, and she isn't coming until tomorrow. Her runes of healing can cure people who are sick in no time. But Laura probably won't survive through the night without those herbs. Runes of healing? Envoy? That's why I came all this way. Someone told me there were amazing healing herbs near here. They said they can cure anything and that they're especially good for fevers. So, well, I know it's reckless of me to be out here. We're not really ever supposed to leave the village. Really? Well, yes, nobody's ever supposed to leave. Isn't it like that in your village, too?
Kind of.
The only ones permitted to go outside the village are the envoys chosen to be servants of the gods. God?
No, she said gods.
I'm sorry, but can you explain what you mean by the gods and envoys? Nice try, but you won't trick me that easily. Lady Mash, girl in black armor. People have always told me that the only envoys of the goddesses have swords or spears. But I didn't know you use shields, too. That's amazing, Lady Mash. Wait, me, an envoy?
You know.
Senpai?
Anyway, let's go look for those medicinal herbs.
Hooray! I was hoping you might offer to help me. Or does that mean you can read my mind? Even if you don't have any weapons of your own, Mr. Blackhair, you must be an envoy of the gods too.
I am a harbinger of all things critical and negative. I am what you would call the bringer of the negapocalypse. It's basically just where I criticize something until it fucking dies. Although, to be fair, like I've said many times before, I know a lot of people get really mad that I'm overly critical about fate, but I'm overly critical about fate because I care. I feel you just don't care enough when you're just like, fuck it, whatever, just don't pay attention to the shit that doesn't make sense. Like, no, I want it to be better. I want to enjoy it better. I don't want it to just be the same old, oh, this doesn't make sense, but I'm just gonna pretend it does. Bullshit. I want it to be better. So if by some chance I point out a flaw in it and someone somewhere just happens to see it by some mystical fucking chance and they correct it, then I did my job. Please tell me this is over. Please tell me that was... Oh, whoa. I was kind of fucking joking, but okay. Yeah, that was... Why did that need to be its own arrow?